Actually, Kitty, DK is on, I think, his last lap now. It's quite close to him getting a lap more, but I think it's the last one now.
He is on the back straight at the moment, with 15 seconds to go.
Yeah, 10 seconds on my watch now. 5, 4, 3, 2, 0 just after the line. He gets one more lap.
Do we have feet to improve or something like that?
I think race control will now instruct the drivers that this is the last lap of the race.
So maybe you should post the IP address on the TeamSpeak then. Uh-huh.
Well, we can actually do another and perhaps even smarter thing here.
Awesome. So I think it could be quite interesting to talk with some, if not all, of the drivers from the event.
And here we go, final run down the back straight of this, the 2012, and actually the first running of the DGTL 12 hours of sequence.
It was a slow car driving there.
And congratulations to Team Kitty DK with the victory, and congratulations to Formula Yamaha for the GT class win.
I have to say it was absolutely a brilliant race.
We have a bit of an interesting situation here, because what has actually happened is that the podium of the LMP class will include on third place Team Easier, if I am not mistaken. The Team Easyon car is still the LMP car that has done the third most laps.
That's correct, yes. Indeed.
So even though they haven't finished, if we have to fill a podium with LMP drivers, it will have to include the driver of Team Easyon.
Indeed. But just didn't hear what you said before. But yes, indeed.
Yes, of course, the winning GT card, Formula Yamaha, and in second place the 10-man project, and third place goes to the Team Bernie Racing. And I've just checked with the bookmakers. That is pretty much the result that the entire world was expecting, at least in GT.
I just thought LMP, that'd be... Wait, what?
Well, congratulations to the drivers, and thanks to everyone for participating.
Yeah, this has definitely been an exciting event. people have been driving remarkably nicely, so not really any incidents for the race control. Quite a few server restarts, but I think that's a good thing. It meant that we could have a large grid for the whole race, and it has been some very exciting racing at times.
Yes, I think this again just shows what a great idea this whole thing about the safety car procedures and server restarts has really been, and how you really, even though you've got a game that is quite faulty on internet connection, can be run in a way so that an event is satisfying for everyone to participate in. I don't think anyone will disagree that this has been a good day to a good way to spend a Saturday in the middle of the winter.
I think it's been a good way to use the day in the winter, drinking some beer with the maid, watching some racing. That's fine. Not really. I think it's been a great way to watch. Although it's always more fun to be competing than, well, I guess it's the second best thing. I guess it's just not my thing to race in this long wind stuff. It doesn't go right for me.
Looks like the safety car has joined the race now.
I'll see what I can do here to get some driver interviews.
Yes, go ahead.
I will just have to test here that we have sound with us on the stream. And it looks like we do.
So I'll just I'm just back here to get my well-deserved applause.
Nice done. Beautiful lab. Just amazing.
Thank you, but save something for the race winners.
If I just interrupt here and instruct everyone to go back to the GTL TeamSpeak server in the SimRace TV room for race interviews. Hello everyone, and welcome to the post-race interviews.
Thank you, Raza.
Well, actually, first we would like to hear from the drivers, from the winning LMP car, from Team Kitty. Can you first tell us a little bit about your preparations for this race?
Our preparations were not so good because we didn't have any plans actually. We just took it to where it led us.
So this is in fact the physical way of sticking it to the man.
Yeah, you could say that. No, we had no expectations at all, because we knew we had a fast car, but 12 hours is a very, very long race, and as you all could see, it developed in 4 different directions, I think. So it was first here the last half hour we knew that it was good.
Yes, and we noticed that you definitely had the pace. Your lap times were pretty much faster than the other cars that actually completed the race. But we also noticed that you had quite a few number of incidents and extra pit stops.
Yeah, we had to have an extra trailer with the splitters, because I think we lost 5 or 6 or so. So yeah, we had a lot of accidents, unfortunately. In the beginning of the race, every time we had made a gap to number 2 or number 3, the pace car went out, and we got caught up again. So I think that overall we are lucky that so many connections were lost.
Yes, for sure, disconnections have been playing into this race, but in the end there were only 2 cars that did not have disconnections, and those are indeed the winning cars in the 2 classes.
Yeah, it was a very nice race, I think. It was long, but it was nice.
That's good to hear from you. And now from Henning, the second place, Henning from the FTC LMP car, the overall second car and second car in LMP class. What is your view on the race?
Yeah, it was a pretty hectic raised for us, because we were in yesterday evening to see that Tim Kitty and Nikolai was pretty fast in the night, so and we had in the night in at 48 at the fastest, and I was expect to get a little bit faster when we are in the daytime, and that was pretty much our luck, because the pace from Kitty was with Nikolai pretty much very fast, and we had to rely on the second driver in that car to be able to get a chance to win. But when the night came, Nikolai was, I guess, in the car almost the full time, and that was why we pulled up just second place. But even so, I think it was a very nice planned race, and for all to be proud of, no matter which car it is, but I think it was a good race for us, yes.
Yes, and thank you to you and your team for participating in this race.
No problem at all.
And let's move on to the winning GT car, which is Lasse, who is apparently sitting still in the race frame, ready for this interview. Lasse, can you tell us a little bit about the preparations for this race?
Well, we've been preparing for quite a few weeks, although not very intensively, but we have put a lot of work into to the setup. As usual, most of our testing is with the goal of making a good race setup, which is quick and oversteery, but not dangerous, and easy to control is also one of the things we're also always aiming for. And so of course we spent a good deal of time finding this sweet spot in the setup.
And how do you think the race panned out according to the preparations?
Well, first of all, we've pretty much chosen the wrong car for this kind of race, because we've had all these technical difficulties, numerous restarts, 4 or 5 restarts, I think it was. Then there was the period where we had to restart the whole server and the router, and it's been full of stoppages in the racing, which means that the advantage we get from having such an economical car like the Lissa Storm, that kind of fades away. Because we are not allowed to have those several consecutive stints that allow us to really get our advantage out of having an economic car. So we've kind of had to throw that out the window and really go for going quicker than we had anticipated. But it panned out, and the setup could hold up to it, although that the car is a bit down on power for this kind of racing.
Yes, but definitely a good effort by you, Lasse, and thanks for making it interesting for the last hour when you were battling with the 10-man project for fastest lap time in the GT class. That was a good show.
Yeah, that was actually a lot of fun. On our pit radio, we were conspiring to get this pit stop right and the tires just right, and we were calculating how much fuel we'd need. But in the end, you need a really, really good run to get this car under 1 minute and 53 seconds. So it is possible. I think I've done 52.4 something close to the line while we were practicing. But we weren't able to deliver such a crazy time to beat the guys from the 10-man project, unfortunately. But unfortunately, I am I'm happy that we are actually on the same team. So
yes, and of course, winning the race, of course, which was very important. And then on to second in the GT class, the 10-man project. Let's hear a little bit about your preparations. I know that you've been hindered by some skiing vacations.
Yeah, that's my excuse. And Chris have been without his racing wheel for 2 weeks. Yesterday night we set, Chris set up to 6 o'clock preparing our setup and so, because we kind of realized that yesterday afternoon that we were not going fast enough.
Well, you were definitely going fast in the race, and you did set the fastest lap time of the race. Can you tell us a little bit about what was happening concerning this this whole thing about the fastest lap?
Yeah, that was quite intense at the end. I think already before the halfway mark, I set a very fast time, and then I stood there for almost until the last 2 hours, where the times began to shrink, and that's the set made a pretty good time. And then we planned out that I could do a whole stint where I let a little bit off the gas in the beginning to save the tires and just burn off some fuel, and then at the end, I could do some fast lap, and that worked out pretty well. And again, I beat Les's currently best time, but that wasn't the end of it. And here at the last hour, we just switched places actually, and then we had the thoughts and that Les would go out on less fuel and on little fuel and with the medium tires. So we planned out to do the same, and Chris said went very fast at that moment, but then again the guys at Formula Yamaha surprised us and did a splashing dash in the end, but not the regular one. They didn't just fuel up, they just went in to put new tires on, and this time was soft tires, so we had to do the same, and that gave me 2 laps at the end to set a really fast time, and I must say, a time that is 0.3 of a second faster than our pole position qualified time. That's I amazed myself, I must say.
That's also new to us, because I just realized when you told me this that if we had just waited until late enough to make this last change of tires, splash and dash pit stop, we could have actually put up a time that you couldn't beat because you couldn't make the pit stop. So actually that's a pretty big fault on our side concerning this fastest lap charade. I wanted to talk to some of the guys from Team Bernie Racing, but I can see they are still in their own TeamSpeak channel. I could try to move them up here and see if they have anything they want to contribute with, because they actually provided us with some of the best... Yes, and we now here, I hope, have Michael Bernberg from the Team Bernie Racing. Are you there, Michael? He's alive. Something is happening.
Yes, I'm here now.
Oh, thanks, Michael. I just wanted to congratulate you on the third place in the GT class, and just mention that you actually and your team provided us with some of the best sim racing that we've seen in a long time, in quite a few laps when you were battling the 10-man project car for the second place. Can you perhaps tell us a little bit about your preparations for the race, and then perhaps take us through what you thought when you were or your teammate were driving and battling for this position?
Yeah, first of all, I had my teammate Jan Brodskoy today. It was only his second race online, and he did a pretty good job. And my setup wasn't too bad, but it's not I'm not the best at setups, but we could go pretty fast. And the battle I had with the 10-man project, that was just fun. A lot of fun.
Yes, I think we'll have to find that in the recordings of this, and make a little special video out of that to show people how to properly race in sim racing, because that was extremely extremely well executed.
Yeah, it was great fun. And congrats to the winners.
Yes, and I think we'll round off here. And yes, congratulations to the winners, and congratulations to you and your teammate Michael on the third place in the GT class. And thanks to everyone for participating in this wonderful and first 12-hour online race for the Danish Grand Touring League. It was in the end, after all the disconnects and all the technical issues, I think it was actually a pretty good event, and I do not think it is possible to do it that much better when you are racing online. So thank you to everyone, and thank you for participating, and thanks to SimRace TV for letting us broadcast this event.
The operator.